Anthony Albanese has welcomed his Kiwi counterpart, Jacinda Ardern, with open arms. His first guest since his election win. And as a gesture of that goodwill, the PM today promised that he would work through New Zealand's concerns over the deportation of its citizens who commit serious crimes. It's an issue that's been a thorn in the relationship, but both leaders say they're committed to a trans-Tasman reset.
Hosting his first diplomatic visit as Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese gladly welcomed his New Zealand counterpart, inviting Jacinda Ardern to Kirribilli House on his very first night in the Sydney residence.
We had a wonderful dinner together last night.
Gifting each other vinyl.
The team were very impressed by your album choice.
The pair bonding over their shared love of music.
Probably the only two people who've ever been elected Prime Minister who DJ.
The relationship between the leaders in stark contrast to the previous government.
I do see this as an opportunity for a reset because, you know, there were obviously some points of friction. There's obviously still issues to be worked through.
And that is the issue of deportation under Section 501 of the Migration Act.
Our long-standing expectation that Australia not deport individuals who have lived in Australia for a long time and are essentially Australians.
This section of the Act allows for the deportation of New Zealand citizens who commit crimes no matter how long they've been in Australia.
Often zero connection to New Zealand, sometimes not even having stepped foot there.
Prime Minister Albanese vowing to work through these concerns.
Section 501 should be maintained, but there is also concerns have been raised that need to be taken into consideration as friends.
As friends, they've also committed to strengthening trans-Tasman relations, particularly on climate change and driving down emissions in the region.
It's like Australia has gone out of the naughty corner.
New Zealand is heartened and welcomes the ambition that has been expressed by the new government.
Remaining in lockstep on the Pacific.
We're a part of the Pacific. They're our partners.
We've heard a lot of dialogue about the Pacific, not much of a chance for the Pacific to speak for themselves.
Stella Todorovic for 10 News First.